Today, we are going to discuss about the features of planning. So the first features of planning is that planning focuses on achieving the objectives. We know that all the organizations are set up with some general purposes in view, which means they have a general objective or a specific objectives or a things to do so that their objectives can be clearly achieved. And the specific goals are set out in the plans along with the activities to be undertaken to achieve the goals. Thus, planning is purposeful, and that is the reason we call planning to be a purposeful function, because it is deliberately done by the management so that they set up an objectives as well as decide the best suitable alternative which could be taken into action for achievement of that objectives. Planning has no meaning unless it contributes to the achievement of predetermined organizational goals. So even if you have a very good planning, even though you have a very nice strategy, but if you don't convert those plans into actions, if you don't have any objectives or goals, then simply planning is of no use. And hence, planning will have a meaning or a purpose only when there is predetermined objectives or goals which needs to be achieved by the organization. The next feature is that planning is a primary function of management, which means it is the first and the foremost function of management, and all the other managerial functions are performed within the framework of plans drawn. So as I explained to you earlier, it is the first function of management, and all the other functions such as staffing, organizing, directing, control are all done under the framework of the plans which are already being made by the organization. And this is why it is referred as primacy of planning. So that is why it is known as a primary objective. The various functions of management are interrelated and equally important. However, planning provides the basis for all other functions. So even though all the other functions are important and are needed to be carried out very effectively, but planning can be stated as the basis or the ground on which all the other functions of management needs to be carried out. And that is the reason planning is known as the first and the primary function of management. Then it comes, planning is pervasive in nature. See, planning is required in all the levels of management, whether it is top level, they have their own strategies, middle level or lower level, they all require planning, as well as far as departments of the organization is concerned, whether it is production department or financial department, they all need planning. So there is no department, no area in an enterprise which does not involve planning. And so planning is pervasive. It is very important function which needs to be carried out, and not just the top level management or any other board of directors or executive members, all the levels of the organization or the enterprise necessarily needs planning. This can be done with an example as well. Let's understand this with the help of an example. Suppose if there is a top level management, it actually undertakes the activity of planning for the organization as a whole. So the top level management takes the activity of planning for all the levels of management. Then the middle level of management does the departmental planning, which means according to the department, varied upon different departments, these activities take place or planning takes place. And at the lowest level also, day-to-day operations like production, etc., at the worker level or at the supervisory level, planning is done by the supervisors. So even though it is top level, middle level or lower level, management has to undertake the functions of planning at all the levels. The next feature is that planning is a continuous process. We know that till the time the business is there, it exists, till that time planning has to be done. 1 year you have accomplished one goal, you have fetched the profit. Next year again you have to strive for more, plan, and then the process goes on. And so it can be said that plans are prepared for a specific time. Either it could be for a month, quarter, or for a year. At the end of the period, there is a need of new plan to be drawn on the basis of new requirements and future conditions. So if you are planning to expand your business or continue with your business, once you have accomplished your goal, you are not going to stop your business. You are not going to stop the functioning of the business. And so is the process of planning as well. Even though you have accomplished one goal, for achievement of next requirement and the future condition, you need to plan again. And hence, planning is a continuous process. Continuity of planning is related with the planning cycle. It means that a plan is framed, it is implemented, and is followed by another plan, and so on. So as I explained to you just now, once the organizational goal is achieved, you are striving for more and more. So now in the next financial year, you need another plan, another strategy. Then in the coming years, you need different plans so that these plans can be implemented. And then followed by that would be another plan coming up in the time. So it could be like a cycle which goes on and on forever. And that is why planning is a continuous process. Then the next feature is planning is futuristic. Futuristic means it is done for future purpose. So planning involves looking ahead and preparing for the future. We all know this thing. The purpose of planning is to meet future events efficiently or effectively to the best advantage of an organization. It implies peeping into the future, means it implies that looking into the future. Peeping means to look, analyzing it and predicting it. Planning is therefore regarded as a forward-looking function based on forecasting. So it can be said that planning is a forward-looking function or looking into the future, anticipating the future. Through forecasting, future events and conditions are anticipated and plans are drawn accordingly. So it can be said that even though we are not completely aware about what is going to happen tomorrow, nobody can foresee the future very precisely or very accurately. Right, but if there is a proper planning, managers can somewhat anticipate or somewhat try to understand that yes, these are the changes which we may face in the future, and hence planning will help him to have a look about the future changes. So basically we know that planning is not done for just one step. It is done for all the steps which needs to be taken for ultimately achieving the organizational goals. So hence, planning proves to be a very futuristic activity which helps the management to face the future events with the best possible manner and also to take the best advantages of the resources which are applied in the organization. And hence, planning is a futuristic activity, which means it helps to foresee or anticipate or have a look or peep into the future and know somewhat, it helps to know about the changes which might come in the future, and it also helps to prepare for the future. The next feature is that planning involves decision making. Planning essentially involves choices from among various alternatives and activities, which we have already discussed. There are various alternatives available, and the manager should identify or choose from the alternatives and activities. If there is only one possible goal or a possible course of action, then there is no need of planning because there is no choice. So if tomorrow you face a situation that you don't have any alternative, you don't have any other option, then do you need planning? No, but this scenario will definitely not occur as far as business is concerned. They will always have alternatives. They will always have alternative activities and choices, and hence planning becomes very important in the area of decision making for business. The need of planning arises only when alternatives are available. In actual practice, planning purposes the existence of alternatives. Planning thus involves thorough examination and evaluation of each alternative and choosing the most appropriate one. So what is this decision making? When you are made available with many choices, many alternatives, as a manager, you need to choose one best amongst them. So what do you do? You decide over it. Yes, I need this plan, or I need this course of action or activity in order to achieve my organizational goal. So what are you doing there as a manager? You are making your decisions. You are taking the decisions for your organization. So planning will help you to set a standard and then measure the actual performance with the standard. And if there is any deviation, it will also help you to examine and evaluate the cause of deviation. And it will help you to examine and evaluate the alternatives or the choices which are most appropriate for the upbringing of your organization. And hence, planning proves to be a very fruitful or helpful activity in the process of decision making. The next feature of planning is that planning is a mental exercise. It is a very important feature. Planning requires application of mind, involving foresightedness, intelligent imagination, and source of judgment. It is basically an intellectual activity. If you have to do planning, you will not get any crash course for it. You need to use your intellectual, your thinking skills, your problem solving skills, your analytical skills, your judgment skills. And so that is why it means that it is an intellectual activity. You need to think with your brain. You need to focus on your consciousness. You need to be very sharp at thinking in order to become a very good planner. And that is why it is known as intellectual activity of thinking rather than doing, because planning determines the actions to be taken. However, planning requires logical and systematic thinking rather than guesswork or wishful activities. So you know that if you are an organization running on a large scale business, tomorrow you feel that, okay, let's plan out this thing, but I'm not very sure about it. There is no scope of the word not sure about it. When you are planning something, even though you are completely not able to anticipate, but with your skillful thinking, with your analytical skills or problem solving skills, which is your intellectual thinking, you should actually able to identify the logical and systematic thinking which involves to take the decisions regarding planning. You cannot simply go for guesswork or wishful thinking saying that I wish it happens like this. No, because the business environments are completely dynamic and nobody can predict what is going to happen in the future. And therefore, planning is an intellectual activity. We need mind, sharp brain, as well as thinking must be very apt and particular. In other words, thinking for planning must be orderly and based on analysis of facts and forecast. So you can say that the planning process should be based on analysis of facts as well as forecast, which means looking into the future. So planning should not be simply done on guesswork or wishful thinking. It should be based on clear and analytical data, facts and figures. So these were the few features of planning that we have discussed in today's class.